for the show, don't be wary. Our dapper MC is Handsome Jim Perry on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Did you hear that poem? Now, we finally got a poem. Ah, that was a poem. I ask you. Gene, it's possible that some of the audience didn't hear that opening poem. Would you repeat the poem, Gene?
I'll be glad to, Jim. Here we go. Stay tuned for the show. Don't be wary. The show is great, in spite of Jim Perry.
Went that way?
We're kidding around, but thank you, Mildred Gregory of Hazleton, Pennsylvania, for the opening poem. Now let's meet our champion who's going to play the money cards, Debbie Williams. Hello, Debbie. Good to see you.
Hi.
Are you relaxed now?
A little.
You know, of course, that the champion who you replaced won over $39,000.
I know that.
You going to do as well?
I hope so. I want to retire.
Good, good, good. That's the way to feel. You won $200 in the game, and now we're going to go for the big money. Good luck, Debbie. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on up here, Deb. Debbie, the $200 you won in the game, yours to keep. Now with a brand new deck of cards all shuffled and cut, we'll give you new money to play with. Starting on the bottom line with $200, we'll give you these three cards. Bet them as you will. Move up to the second level, another $200 of betting money and three more cards. Your minimum bets are $50 until you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must bet at least half the money. A lot of money up there, Deb. Relax. Think about it. Play them good. Here's $200. As in the game, you have a choice of two base cards on the bottom level. When you move up to the second level, you can change your base card. And before you make the big bet again, you can change that base card. We want to give you every opportunity to make money. You're starting with a five. Do you want to play that or change it?
I'll keep that card and say $100
higher. $100
higher
than a five? She's right with a nine. $300 now. Kind of a middle card, though, Deb.
Okay. $200 lower.
Big bet on a nine. Two-thirds of the money. $200 lower than a nine. Yes, with an eight. Now you are right up the middle with an eight and $500.
$100. It's going to be higher.
$100 higher than an eight. No, it's a four. But you didn't bet too heavy, so you're down to $400. Up goes the four. We give you the other $200 of betting money. $600. Do you want that four on this level?
Yes, I want the four. I bet $500 it's going to be higher.
We haven't seen a face card yet. This would be a great time for one. $500 higher than a four. A nine. It's higher. $1,100, Debbie. And again, a middle card. Big bet on a nine. $400 lower than a nine. No, it's a ten. Down to $700. You've had some tough cards, Debbie, but there are still two to go. With that ten and $700, what do you want to do here?
I'm going to bet $500 again. It's going to be lower.
Big bet again on the ten. $500 lower than a ten. Another ten. Terrible cards. You're down to $200. Up goes the ten. Do you want to play that on the big bet? Watch. I can bet this is going to be a good card. Changing the 10 to a jack. Well, a little bit better.
I'll bet all of it it's going to be lower.
All right. For nothing or $400, which is pretty good cab fare, Debbie. Lower than a jack. No. Another jack. 5, 9, 8. The 4, 9, 10, 10, jack, jack. They were awful cards, Deb. But you are the champion. You're still here. That's the big thing. Come on down here with me. You're going to defend the title. Maybe get another chance to get up there and win some money.
Oh, I hope so. I've got to retire.
That's the way to feel. We'll meet a new challenger and start the match right after this commercial message. Really tough. Back with our champion, Debbie Williams. Debbie, you got some tough cards up there. But you were really eager to retire. You were betting like two-thirds of the money on the sevens, eights, and nines. You want to make it all at one time, huh?
Yes.
Yes, that's... Why not? Yes, absolutely. Okay, Debbie, here we go again. Let us open the board and get to the cards. And Janice and Bettina will start loading into brand new decks of cards, and we'll meet our next challenger on Card Sharks. Joe Leisha. Hi, Joe.
How are you doing?
Good to meet you.
I know.
Won't you tell us about yourself?
Okay, my name is Joe Leisha. I'm from Chatsworth, California, originally from Cairo, Egypt. I'm an engineer. I'm working research. I love sports. I like to dance. In fact, one of my favorite kind of dance, believe it or not, is belly dancing.
Belly dancing?
Yes.
How do you... Hold down the stomach, won't it, Joe?
Oh, you bet, just... you know.
Good luck, Joe. Good luck to both
of you. Thank
you. Each player has a deck of 52 playing cards. They're shuffled, and the players cut them before we go on the air. Debbie, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Joe, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. Before he can begin calling high-low on the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question. And Debbie, we start with a question to you. We asked 100 women who support the women's liberation movement, would you be flattered if a man told you he thought you were stacked? How many feminists said they would be flattered?
I think a lot of women want to say, you know, looks aren't important, but deep down inside, they're all very vain. I think it's going to be very high, so 80.
80 would be flattered if a man said they were stacked.
Oh, I would say it would be lower than that. Women like to be feminine all the time, you know,
right.
And they don't want to compete with men.
Don't
want
to say they're stacked,
no,
right?
No.
Okay, so you say lower. The question is, how many said they would be flattered if they said they were stacked?
Right.
Right. The actual number of feminists who would be flattered if a man told them they were stacked is 19.
Yeah.
Joe, it's lower.
Woo.
Oh, well. Very
All
much
right.
lower.
All right.
See, they weren't that shallow, Debbie. Joe, you're starting with a big ace.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. I like that. I go lower.
Lower than an ace.
Yes.
With a 10. Remember, you can freeze it any time.
Freeze right there.
Gonna freeze it there. Over goes
like
the freeze bar. Can't take those cards away from you. And, of course, that keeps Debbie away from her cards.
Right.
Joe, we asked 100 bachelors. Be honest, are you lonely? Mm-hmm. How many bachelors admitted they were lonely? Aww.
For bachelors.
All together now. Aww.
Bachelors, usually, they feel lonely. But there is a lot of loose women around. And so they keep themselves busy. So they would say...
That's a good way to put it, Joe. They keep themselves busy.
Yeah.
But how many bachelors admitted they were lonely?
But they still feel lonely because they can't find the right person to fill in. So
right.
they will be about 40, we'll say, they are lonely.
40?
Yes.
Is the show over yet? He says 40 admitted they were lonely, Debbie.
I think it's going to be higher.
Higher?
Higher.
More
it's got to be.
Well, the actual number of bachelors who admitted they were lonely is 27, not higher,
yeah,
Joe.
Right. I change the base card, please.
Yes, you won the question. You have the right to change the base card to a 9.
Oh.
Not a good change. Got to play that one.
Yeah, I will go lower.
Lower than a 9? No, it's a jack. It is not lower. And that gives Debbie a free chance to play a jack.
Oh, good card. Lower. Lower.
Lower than a jack. Yes, a 5. Risking that one and this one higher, it is a 9.
Freeze!
Debbie freezes with a 1-card advantage. Janice will fill in the space for Joe. And the question to you, Debbie. We ask 100 married women. Does your husband earn enough money? How many women said their husband does earn enough money?
There's never enough money. I think that number is going to be low. Oh, 25.
She says 25 women say their husband does earn enough money, Joe.
I think the number will be a little bit higher than that because there is a lot of women around that satisfied also.
Right,
with what
and they're meeting the bachelors who are not lonely.
Well,
I got you thinking now, Joe.
Make it up.
The actual number of women who said their husband does earn enough money is 51. It's higher, Joe.
Isn't it nice to know
they're satisfied? Joe won the question. You have the right to change the 9 to a king.
Yeah, beautiful, beautiful. I go lower.
Lower than a king.
Beautiful,
yes, for the 4.
Beautiful. I go higher.
Higher than a 4. It is a 5.
I like to freeze right there.
Freezing. Joe needs 1 card. Debbie needs 2. Sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Joe, our man on the street, went to Nashville, Tennessee, where he asked 100 people, have you ever eaten grits? How many people in Nashville said yes?
Oh, the number would be low there. You know, Nashville eating grits?
Grits?
Oh.
I must tell you that in the South, grits is a common type of eating. Now, whether these people in the poll or Nashville, I don't know. But yeah. Grits is common. I'm mentioning that because you're from
Egypt. It is common, but you are sick from it, you know.
Oh, I see. Oh, of course. Well, how many people in Nashville said, yes, they have eaten grits?
Okay, the number would be 65.
65?
Yeah.
Grits is rice with sand in it. Isn't that what it is? I mean, no. You said lower. The actual number of people in Nashville, Tennessee who have eaten grits is 66.
Yeah!
It's not lower,
right,
Joe.
Right.
Joe, with your logic, you almost hit it on the button. Now listen carefully. It's sudden death, Joe. You need one card. Debbie needs two. Do you want to play it or pass it?
I will pass it.
You'll pass it to Debbie. You didn't win the question, Debbie. You must play the nine. You got to call them both right to win. One mistake and Joe wins. What's this card? Lower than a nine. No, it's not. Joe wins it in sudden death. It's a king. Game one to the challenger and $100. Champion's got to make a comeback coming up right after this.